Hi, my name's Andy Tillison from The Tangent, and you're watching, listening to Morrow.com, Progressive Rock Radio. The future is not as good as the book. I think this is just a sort of like wry and sort of cynical look at the modern world. Is that like many people my age, we remember when I was 10 years old, I was watching Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin land on the moon, and I was watching Concorde fly across the Atlantic at the speed of sound. I was aware of Jimi Hendrix playing the Woodstock Festival. I was looking at peace and love. I was looking at exploration. I was looking at a fantastic time, the end of the 1960s. And music was beginning to do this progression thing, you know. And really, the music of that time was very much influenced by an era of progressive feelings. And really, by the time we reached 1977, the whole punk rock thing came in, and there were strikes and problems, and so that during my youth, I was looking at the future and thinking it would all be holidays on Mars, and there'd be no more wars, we wouldn't have money anymore. But I was only 10 years old, you see, and I thought we'd all be travelling on hover cars and on monorails and doing all these wonderful things, and the future would be rather like Star Trek, you know, with exploring space and doing these really cool things and helping out in the universe. But when I got to the future, we passed 2001 a long time ago, and we haven't been to Saturn yet, we haven't been to Mars, and the internet's pretty cool, but it's also pretty bad, you know, and we have it's really a case of there's still a lot of wars, there's still a lot of money, there's still a lot of hunger in the world, and it's just that I had a vision of the future, but the future wasn't as good as the book. That's it. that's the title track of the CD. The first CD is really the first CD itself is seven songs, which are really about life in middle age. I think all rock songs do tend to concentrate on emotions felt by younger people. Whether that be innocent love songs, whether it be songs of teenage rebellion, songs about school, songs about, you know, teenage angst in general. There's a lot of that in music. And owing to some personal experiences that I had over the past couple of years, I had to really kind of like come to terms with who I am again, and find out who is Andy Tillison right now. And I think the thing that I felt most was that, you know, I was just a very ordinary middle-aged man, 48 years old, and I kind of thought, well, that's it then, I'm 48. I thought, well, nobody writes songs about people who are 48. Nobody really bothers about people who are 48. In fact, if you watch a television programme, you'll watch a programme with an old detective who's a really wise, grey-haired old detective, and his boring assistant will be 48 years old. Or if you watch a programme about some young tearaway who's, you know, really glamorous, wants to be in a rock and roll band, and he's a rebel and that kind of stuff, you'll find that his dad is 48 years old, right? We're never the glamorous people. So that's what the first album's about, different aspects of that. The second disc is entirely different. That's a disc about conflicts. The first series of conflicts being the war in Iraq that took place, and I had to wonder, where are all the songs about this? Where are all the songs with people saying, no, we don't want this war? Because there didn't seem to be any this time round. There have been songs about it, obviously, but they haven't been well publicised, and they certainly haven't been as prolific as Hendrix, Dylan, Jim Morrison, Janis Joplin, Joni Mitchell were during the time of Vietnam. So I did this song, Four Egos, One War, and then the other song on the album is about a more personal conflict, so person to person. Antoine Ettery is an amazing young artist who's from the Gers in southern France. He's currently studying at the L'École Émile Cole, which is in Lyon. He's still studying art there. I first saw his work in 2007 and asked him if he'd be interested in working for the group, because we'd done a lot of album sleeves with our previous guy, Ed Unitsky. He's done 5 album sleeves for us, and he's done 3 for Guy Manning's band, and he's also started to work for the Flower Kings now. So we kind of thought, right, okay, we'll have a little change here. I saw Antoine's work, thought this will fit really nicely with the story of the book, it's fit nicely with the album, because he can illustrate little chapters in the story and the album's lyrics. And so we had a long conversation, worked it all out, and he came up with some astounding sketches and drawings, and we just said, go for it. And it's great, because like Ed Unitsky, who was completely new when he arrived with us, he did his first published work properly for The Tangent, his first album sleeve. He's since gone on to be able to work with people like Star Castle and Flower Kings. So we thought, well, let's give another artist a chance to shine and do something completely different. I think The Tangent's always had a fairly strong idea of how to try and make a record look good and feel like an interesting thing to look at. And on this album, we've tied everything in with a novel, and the pictures go exceptionally well with it, I think. So I'm very impressed with it. And it's also nice to learn more about bande dessinée, because the French comic style is something we don't know a lot about in England. We know a lot about the American comic book style. And I was visiting Toulouse. I went to the festival of bande dessinée at Toulouse and was just amazed by the amount of styles and varieties that there are there, and how vastly different it is from the American style. So it's very nice to learn about this and to incorporate something new into the music. This woman is top case. The other half in his sack. France has got better weather. France has got my girlfriend. This is just where I've chosen to live now. I came to France once before. On a personal level, it didn't work out, but I very much did like France and the people here. I like the atmosphere and the way of life. So I've decided, you know, that this was the way to go for me. I met somebody new in France, and I've decided to come and live with them here. And I'm having a great time. After a war. Très bien. Je suis très enchanté de parler avec un site web français. Et j'espère que tout le monde aime notre album. Et s'ils n'en aiment pas, on peut nous excuser. C'est très bien de te rencontrer. Merci beaucoup pour entendre cette interview. Et au revoir, à bientôt. Bon appétit et le vache qui rit.